From the OU TV Broadcast Center in Los Angeles, California, this is Brief News Brief, a brief look at today's trending news topics. Proudly combating the thought police since 2016, here's your host, James Heaney.
I'm James Heaney, and this is your Brief News Briefing. To heckle or not to heckle? That's the question. Is incivility contagious? Is it like a virus? Many people are starting to question if we're just too plain mean to each other lately. Are we just acting too toxic? The debate has hit a new gear. When Sarah Huckabee Sanders was asked to leave a Virginia restaurant over the weekend because employees didn't want to serve her, it can be argued that that was the nicer route. They could have served Sarah Huckabee Sanders something she didn't want to be served. Secretary of Homeland Security Kirstjen Nielsen was heckled out of a Mexican restaurant just last week, the same day that she made a statement to the public about why it was okay for the government to be involved in state-sanctioned child abuse on the Mexican border. Was she just trolling the people? Did she not realize that it's a little out of touch to go to a Mexican restaurant the same day as that? This activity led Senator Maxine Waters to double down on the public disapproval, and she called for more of these types of confrontation. Trump responded by saying that Maxine Waters has brain damage. He tweeted that the Virginia restaurant that Sarah Huckabee Sanders was kicked out of, he said that it was a dump, mentioning something about the paint on the walls. I don't know. And then on Sunday, in this whirlwind of crazy name-calling, a man on Fox and Friends made this comment. Roll the clip.
Final point,
Michael Hayden. All right,
you said that about David.
Michael Hayden posted a picture of Auschwitz. Donnie Deutsch
is
talking.
That liberal Michael Hayden. Yeah, look, screaming liberal Michael Hayden.
You're out of your cotton-picking mind.
Cotton-picking mind?
Brother, let me tell you something. I got some relatives who pick cotton, and I'm not going to allow you to laugh at me like that on TV.
Is the solution to stand down and be walked all over? This country has free speech for a reason, and it's in part to speak out against injustice. Trump has led the way with the rhetoric from day one, calling Mexicans rapists, making fun of disabled reporters, discrediting news organizations, discrediting the Justice Department, calling John McCain weak for being captured while in the line of duty. But his base loves this stuff. The meaner he is, the more they cheer him on. In the era of Obama, the general rule was not to go low. Don't get into the dead with the bully. But now the bully's been running the country for a year and a half. Should we just really keep taking the high road, or should we fight back? If you are disgusted by what you're seeing, should you stay quiet because you don't want to ignite a hard right-winger vote surge in the fall? A recent study shows that the more people witness and experience rudeness, the more they are predisposed to interpret any action as rude and then act towards others in a rude way. It's like a virus. Yet some liberals and opponents of President Trump are done with playing nice. Harley Davidson announced this week that it will be moving its productions out of the U.S. due to new trade taxes with the EU. Trump hit back and threatened the iconic motorcycle company Harley Davidson with severe tax penalties for leaving and predicted a public revolt that he said would eventually put the 115-year-old firm out of business. The tariffs that are motivating this motorcycle manufacturer's move are part of the new and ongoing trade war, which is in its early stages of battles right now, right? This is a direct product of Trump's tariffs on steel and aluminum imports from the EU. The company's announcement sparked a massive sell-off in the stock market amid fears that other companies might follow suit. Almost every recent dip in the stock market is reactions to fears of this trade war escalation. On Tuesday, Trump wrote, of course, on Twitter, Harley must know that they won't be able to sell back into the US without paying a big tax. Now, it was unclear what exactly he meant, but he could be referring to the tariffs that he's attempting to unilaterally impose on imports. Numerous countries are moving forward with retaliatory tariffs against the United States. Trump suggested Tuesday morning that his adversarial approach to the trade policy had only begun. Bum, bum, bum! Today, the Supreme Court ruled in a 5-4 decision that President Trump has the authority to ban travelers from certain majority Muslim countries. This is because the court decided that in terms of national security, the president has the authority to control immigration on this level if he thinks it's necessary to protect the United States. The president, of course, reacted on his formal medium called Twitter. Supreme Court upholds Trump travel ban. Wow. This is a huge victory for President Trump. The travel ban was one of the very first legislations Trump tried to push through when taking office last year. The administration has called this ruling a vindication following months of hysterical commentary. The media and Democratic politicians who refuse to do what it takes to secure our border and country. I don't know why I gave it just a generally skeevy, evil voice of the GOP. Not sure. Justice Sonia Sotomayor wrote a stinging rebuttal and was joined in it with Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. She said that the majority's decision repeats tragic mistakes of the past and tells members of minority religions in the United States they are outsiders. Sotomayor compared the decision to Korematsu versus the United States, in which the Supreme Court in 1944 upheld the detention of Japanese Americans during World War II. Roberts objected, Korematsu has nothing to do with this case. It was the first time in the High Court that it had considered the merits of a policy that has consumed the administration since its start. It raised questions mostly about the judiciary's role in national security issues, and the Supreme Court decided that this should be left up to Commander-in-Chief and not the courts. The case will be known as Trump v. Hawaii. Trump wins, Hawaii loses. The CBO, oh, I'm sorry, I don't mean to make you feel out of place. It's the Congressional Budget Office. I got your back, bro. You don't have to worry. Don't ask about it. Anyways, they came out today and said that the government is on track to hit new historic high levels with their debt, the highest levels since 1946 during World War II. At its current growth rate, we're saying the debt will be nearly equal to the size of the U.S. economy by 2028. What? That can't be true, right? Well, that's what they're telling us, and I believe that they're the experts. It's the CBO. The 1946 high was prompted by a spending push to fund World War II. And other spikes that we've had in debt have been driven by economic downturns. But this current bump, this is coming amid a relatively healthy economy. It's actually doing pretty good. So why are we just bumping up this spending compared to collecting taxes? It's a structural gap between how much the country collects in taxes and how much it's spending. That's what's happening right now. The CBO projects that the Republican tax law passed last fall is going to add $1.84 trillion to the federal deficit over the next 10 years. Now, Republican leaders are arguing that these cuts are going to jumpstart the economy, which, for the record, is already okay. It doesn't need jumpstarting. It's like getting a jump for your car while you're driving. Creating this economic growth that's going to offset the alleged debts. That's what they're saying. But the CBO and other nonpartisan analysts have repeatedly rejected that claim. The CBO projects that the debt is rising very quickly with a particularly fast growth in the amount America spends on its debt interest payments. Interest costs are expected to be approximately double as a share of the economy over the next decade and even overtake the cost of funding Social Security, which is the biggest expenditure in the federal budget. Are we rolling off a financial cliff? Hold on to your butts, America.